Ah, yes. A little bit of happiness in tonight's programme. Mad happy we were in November, just out of lockdown. But that was November, and Eddie, that was Dublin. It's some grueling schedule. Two games against... It's effectively five tests here, isn't it?
Pretty much, yeah. Then a couple of the two of the morning games are midweek games, so it's a really hard juggle for Test rugby to play a midweek game because you're trying to get ready for Saturday, which takes usually a week, and then in the middle of it you've got another team to get ready. So that logistics, there'll be a lot of players on tour, north of 40, I would think. The overarching picture as well is they're very happy pictures in November, but New Zealand are waiting for us to come back.
What's the news on New Zealand?
Well, because the news is there's a lot of cockpit chatter in New Zealand that effectively they aren't progressing as a team. You know, the players are there, but they're not advancing or their game, their style of rugby. They've kind of been in a plateau and they need to see some change. So there's pressure on the New Zealand management to deliver now. Were they to lose the test series to Ireland, you know, over three tests, I think there'd be a lot of flack around that. So that puts extra pressure on New Zealand, so still come out swinging.
Well, I did ask a question about New Zealand because we just haven't seen them since then, and you just don't know in the middle of a World Cup cycle where they are in terms of personnel and have they changed their style of play. All will be revealed, but I mean, it's still the same old Johnny Sexton debate here.
Yeah, I mean, that's the biggest challenge for us. I mean, we're talking about Ireland picking maybe 42 or 3 players going down. Most of the players pick themselves. But the big debate for me, it's whatever, 16 months out from the World Cup, Johnny Sexton, clear number one at 10. Joey Carberry just hasn't got back to the level that he was at. Jack Carty is out injured. So you're going to bring a minimum of 3 out halves. That opens a door for one of the younger brigade. Like the likes of Ross Byrne and Billy Burns have been there before. And I think Andy Farrell has put a line through their names. Does he bring a young fella like...
Where's next on the depth chart, as
well,
they say?
That's
Ben Healy?
Well, you've Healy and Crowley and Munster. You have Kieran Frawley. Everybody talks about him in a Leinster kind. I think Frawley is worth bringing to New Zealand on the basis... He's always played well for Leinster. He's played 10, 12, 13. We haven't seen any of him really at 10. But given that you have those two midweek games against the Maori, huge opportunity there. We have to find backup to Tyke Furlong at tight head. I thought Tom O'Toole was outstanding in the last two games. I think he'll go there. And the other question is full back. Hugo Keenan is number one. Who's the backup? You fellas like, you know, Jimmy O'Brien and Mike Haley have had good games. I think Mac Hansen might get a game at fullback.
Question mark
with
Michael Lowry as well, whether he's going to be available.
I think he's
we don't
injured.
Know. Yeah. He looks like he's in trouble. It's a serious injury.
So 15 is an issue. But what about back to where we started with Leinster's defeat? What about the whole power thing? I mean, I know New Zealand in the last few years haven't been basing their game on power as much as previous, as much as the South Africans or English, but they're still always powerful.
You have to. They are a powerful team, but they have changed their kind of DNA in recent years. They've decided way back that they weren't going to go to the power game. They slimmed down their players. If you look, they went for players who are much quicker, more agile, depending on skills. So I don't think they'll overpower us. And I thought, we've seen that in recent years. They haven't been able to overpower us, and they don't try, really. So I think it's going to be about, can they play a more skillful game than us? And if they click, they're very skillful. So that's the key for us. I don't think power's a problem.
Do you give us an outside chance of taking away something here?
I think we could win a test down there. But I think the success in the autumn, when you look back on it, was that we got a lot of things right that day in Dublin. And New Zealand played a very aggressive up and in. If they do the same coming up, we'll catch them again. I can't see them making the same mistake.
Okay.
So we'll have to think around that as well.
Okay.